मैं प्रशांत गहलोत, एंशियंट इंडिया प्राचीन भारत के इस यूट्यूब चैनल में आपका स्वागत करता हूँ। आज का जो हमारा टॉपिक है, वाटर क्वालिटी एंड वाटर क्वालिटी मैनेजमेंट इन एक्वाकल्चर। आज का वीडियो थोड़ा लंबा है, हो सकता है थोड़ा बोरिंग हो, पर आपका पूरा एक्वाकल्चर इन्हीं पैरामीटर्स पे डिपेंड करता है। चाहे आपका वो कार्प का फिश फार्मिंग हो, कैटफिश का फिश फार्मिंग हो, श्रिम्प हो, स्कैम्पी हो, क्रैब हो, या कोई भी आपका एक्वाटिक एनिमल्स, तो सारे पैरामीटर्स आपके वही हैं। तो आप शुरू से लेके लास्ट तक वीडियो कंप्लीट देखिए। अगर आपके कोई डाउट्स हैं तो वो आप हमें कमेंट के थ्रू पूछ सकते हैं। विजन 2020, एंशियंट इंडिया प्राचीन भारत, लो इन्वेस्टमेंट बिजनेस आइडियाज़ एंड सिक्योर योर इन्वेस्टमेंट। Training and knowledge partner, consultant and business planner and partner. Free awareness campaign and educational series for fish and shrimp farming and much more. Advice to ज़रूरी है, we are building the trust. आज का जो हमारा वीडियो है, हमारी बहुत सारी सीरीज में फॉल करेगा। सीरीज 1, fish farming in natural and earthen pond. सीरीज 2, fish farming in cemented pond. सीरीज 3, फिश फार्मिंग इन बायोफ्लॉक टैंक। सीरीज 4, श्रिम्प एंड प्रॉन फार्मिंग इन अर्दन पॉन्ड एंड बायोफ्लॉक कल्चर। सीरीज 6, बेसिक अवेयरनेस वीडियो फॉर फिश फार्मिंग। सीरीज 7, एजुकेशनल वीडियो फॉर फिश फार्मिंग। वाटर क्वालिटी पैरामीटर फॉर एक्वाकल्चर। एक्वाकल्चर कैन बी डिफाइंड एज द हाई डेंसिटी प्रोडक्शन ऑफ फिश एंड अदर एक्वाटिक एनिमल्स इन कंट्रोल्ड एनवायरनमेंट। स्टॉकिंग रेट्स फॉर हाई डेंसिटी एक्वाकल्चर आर टिपिकली 1000-fold ग्रेटर देन वाइल्ड एनवायरनमेंट्स। ओपन सिस्टम सच एज रेसवे आर करेक्टराइज्ड बाई रैपिड टर्न ओवर ऑफ वाटर। क्लोज सिस्टम्स आर कॉमन प्लेस इन पॉन्ड कल्चर ऑफ कार्प, कैटफिशेस, तिलापिया, सीबास, प्रॉन एंड श्रिम्प अमंग अदर्स। क्लोज्ड एक्वाकल्चर सिस्टम डू नॉट हैव रैपिड टर्नओवर ऑफ वाटर बट डू नॉट हैव अ हाई सरफेस टू वॉल्यूम रेशियो फैसिलिटेटिंग एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेस, एनर्जी एक्सेट्रा। विद द सराउंडिंग सच क्लोज सिस्टम इंटेंसिफाइड हाई डेंसिटी एक्वाकल्चर फॉर्म द बेसिस ऑफ कंसर्न। Waste generated by aquaculture faces an unconsumed feed first settle in the bottom as a consequences of organic waste and metabolites of degraded organic matter is accumulated in sediment and water. Part of waste is flushed out of the pond immediately or late after the organic matter has been degraded. Water chemistry. The maintenance of good water quality is essential for both survival and optimum growth of culture organism. The level of metabolites in pond water that can have an adverse effect on growth. Good water quality is characterized by adequate oxygen and limited level of metabolites. The culture organism, algae and microorganisms such as bacteria produce metabolites volatile in a pond. The major source of nutrients in aquaculture is the feed. Because large quantities of feed are loaded in ponds, excess feed, fecal matter and other metabolites become available in large quantities for the growth of algae and microorganisms. The increase in population of algae and microorganisms is exponential. This usually occurs during the second half of the culture period because of available nutrients, about 30% of total feed. Consumption is loaded into the pond during the third quarter of the culture period and about 50% is loaded during the last quarter. The algae and microbial population increase until a factor required for growth becomes limiting, after which a sudden decrease in the population can occur. This is referred to as a collapse or die-off. The sudden increase and decrease in algae and microbial population can cause drastic change in water quality parameter, which may affect the growth of aquatic animals. First important parameter is the temperature. In all the culture system. Aquaculture organisms are cold-blooded animals. They can modify their body temperature to the environment in normal condition. Unlike the warm-blooded animal which can react to maintain the optimum body temperature. Optimum range of the water temperature is 22 degrees centigrade to 35 degrees centigrade as per the culture species. Second important parameter is salinity. Salinity plays an important role in the growth of culture organism through osmoregulations of body minerals from that of the surrounding water. Salinity range from 1 to 45 ppt as per the cultured species. Dissolved oxygen. Atmospheric oxygen crosses the air-water boundary and dissolves in the water matrix. The only way that oxygen can introduce from air to water is by diffusion. Dissolved oxygen is measured either in milligram per liter or parts per million ppm, with 0 ppm representing total oxygen depletion and 15 ppm representing the maximum or saturation concentration. There is about 21% oxygen content in the air. Air acts a big reservoir for oxygen. Concentration in water is limited by its solubility. The solubility of oxygen decreases as the temperature increases. Decreases exponentially with increase in salinity. Decreases with lower atmospheric pressure and higher humidity. Increases with depth. pH. Measure of acidity or alkalinity. pH, or the concentration of hydrogen ion present in pond water, is a measure of acidity or alkalinity. The pH scale extends from 0 to 14, with 0 being most acidic and 14 the most alkaline. pH 7 is a condition of neutral, and routine aquaculture occurs in the range 7.5 to 8.5. It is the optimal range of pH. Greater than pH 9 is dangerous, as ammonia toxicity increases rapidly. At higher temperatures, fishes are more sensitive to pH changes. The pH should be monitored before dawn of the low level and in the afternoon for the high level. An alkalinity above 20 ppm calcium carbonate is preferred in pond. Interventions such as flushing of pond to reduce the pH is advisable when the magnitude of fluctuation in pH is great. Ammonia. Ammonia is the second gas of importance in fish culture. Its significance to good fish production is overwhelming. High ammonia levels can arise from overfeeding, protein-rich excess feed decays to liberate toxic ammonia gases, which in conjunction with the fish's excreted ammonia may accumulate to dangerously high level under certain conditions. It is dependent on pH and temperature. Hardness. Mineral substances are dissolved in water. Among these, the metal calcium and magnesium, along with their counter ion carbonate, comprises the basis for the measurement of hardness. Optimum hardness for aquaculture is the range of 40 to 400 ppm of hardness, or max 500 ppm. Hard water have the capability of buffering the effect of heavy metals such as copper or zinc, which are in general toxic to fish. The hardness is a vital factor in maintaining good pond equilibrium. Turbidity. Water turbidity refer to the quantity of suspended material which interface with light perturbation in the water column. In prawn ponds, water turbidity can result from planktonic organism or from suspended clay particles. Turbidity limits light perturbation, thereby limiting photosynthesis in the bottom layer. Higher turbidity can cause temperature and desaturation in pond. PSB, photosynthetic bacteria. In semi-intensive culture, photosynthetic bacteria plays an important role through absorption and conversion of organic matter into the minerals and nutrients as a secondary production. Compared to the primary production of algae population, PSB exists particularly due to low oxygen level and high intensity of light and can significantly improve the culture environment. Water quality management. The population of phytoplankton and microorganisms are major determinants of the level of oxygen and metabolites in the pond. The diet fluctuation of DO, pH and carbon dioxide serve as indicators of their population. Since carbon dioxide is the major factor affecting the diet fluctuation of pH, monitoring pH fluctuation may be adequate. Also, carbon dioxide is more difficult to measure. Daily measurements are conducted at early hours is 5 to 6 a.m. and afternoon measurement is the 2 to 3 p.m. Most of the water quality problems can be solved with adequate water exchange. Thus, if large quantities of water suitable for aquaculture were available, monitoring would not be as critical and high production level can be targeted. If water is limited, the risk of encountering water quality and disease problem increases as one goes for more intensive culture. Water exchange. The principle of water exchange is to change the water in a way such that the water quality changes gradually instead of abruptly. In semi-intensive system, frequent and sometimes even continuous water exchange at a small flowing rate is employed. Abrupt addition of large quantities of water in a small pond may result in sudden environment change, which subsequently can stress in culture organism. Massive water replacement is not recommended unless there is sudden die-off of plankton, critical low oxygen, or after the application of chemical. Lowering the water level first and adding new water is not recommended. Especially during daytime in summer, increasing water temperature while lowering water level can reduce the capability of water to hold oxygen. Water exchange is the first method to improve pond management, except when good quality of water is not available. A drastic change to the pond environment should be avoided. Culture organisms have been greatly weakened as a result of nutrient depletion and diseases. Ponds are being treated with chemical and medicine. While doing water exchange, several parameters should be noticed such as pH value, salinity, temperature, turbidity and other parameters related to defining good pond environment. Aeration. It increases the dissolved oxygen level of the water and prevents oxygen depletion during the night. It accelerates the diffusion effect of not only the oxygen but also enable the capture of release of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is the important for culture of algae and therefore maintenance of appropriate water color. It facilitates the violation of undesirable gases such as N2, NH3, CH4 and S2S. It reduces the daily fluctuation range of pH value. It controls the value of pH, DO, salinity and temperature in the pond water. It helps in mixing the pond water and maintenance of ideal conditions all over the pond. It increases turbidity when necessary. As the pond water moves in circular fashion, the pond bottom is cleaned and the waste matter gets accumulated in the center and the corner. By this method, most of the pond bottom is kept clean. Removal of dissolved metabolic organics. One of the important stress factors is the increase of dissolved metabolic organics in culture water. It can increase ammonia and microorganism. The best way to facilitate the removal of metabolic waste in a pond is by flushing out water from the bottom. Constantly maintaining high DO in the pond through supplemental aeration and water exchange enhance nitrification. Nitrification is a major mechanism for ammonia removal in well-aerated pond. Aerators are usually operated during dark 7 p.m. to 7 a.m. when oxygen depletion is likely to occur at noon, 12 noon to 2 p.m. when temperature and oxygen esterification can become significant. Pond bottom treatment. For farms adopting advanced technology, it is necessary that pond bottom should be completely dried and aerated to get rid of toxic gases. Many ponds in low-lying area cannot be completely drained and dried. To overcome this, aqua farmers apply waste decomposer to the ponds. They have harmless bacteria and enzymes that consume organic matter on the pond bottom. Maintaining water quality and preventing diseases. Do not overstock. Temperature fluctuation of water, especially during water change, a temporary decline in dissolved oxygen level due to power failure, increase of free carbon dioxide, unionized ammonia and organics due to decaying excess feed and dead animals, poor nutrition, improperly fed fish and prawn, the high level of toxic pollutant in water that may contain heavy metals such as copper, zinc, lead, nickel, mercury and chemicals. This is the main parameter. First is temperature. Maintenance of optimal temperature from 22 degrees centigrade to 32 degrees centigrade. You can measure through mercury digital thermometer. Second is salinity. Tolerance capacity with broad range of salinity. Refractometer, hydrometer, you can check. pH, little bit basic condition are favorable, 7.5 to 8.5 digital pH, pH paper, pH pen, you can check. Transparency, optimal maintenance of plankton density 30 to 40 cm, you can measure through hand method or Saatchi disc. Dissolved oxygen, it is the main requirement of pond ecosystem, DO meter or DO kit. BOD, it is necessary to estimate the request of oxygen content by the enclosed body of water, DO method. COD, the amount of oxygen required for the complete oxidation of all organic components in the pond, oxidized method. Water quality parameter for aquaculture, water parameter, optimal level, temperature 22 degrees centigrade to 35 degrees centigrade. It depends as per the cultured species. Salinity 1 to 45 ppt depends on the cultured species. Dissolved oxygen greater than 3.0 ppm. pH 7.5 to 8.5, it is an ideal condition. Total ammonia nitrogen less than 1.0 ppm. Total nitrate nitrogen less than 5.0 ppm. Nitrite nitrogen less than 0.01 ppm. Saatchi disc visibility 25 to 45 cm. This is our team. Please like, share and subscribe. Also press the bell icon so that you can get the latest update for our upcoming video. Agar aap hamare Telegram group se jodna chahte hain, it is a free initiative, Ancient India Agribusiness. This is the Telegram group name. And you can message me 9971155753. Thank you and